Hello guys, and welcome to another tutorial. And in this tutorial we are going to create that you can have other objects than just the foundation. And also what we are going to change is that you can rotate objects. So the first thing we are going to do is add an empty and call it graphics, and change and other things you see you will put beneath that, and everything, so with a mesh render. Also, I won't create those because that takes too much time. If you want me to create those, just put it in the comments. I will create one, but it will take one part of the series, so I can do it if I am actually also explaining other things, so that's why I didn't do it yet. And for this one, it's a little bit different. Just everything is the same, except we are also going to have a child preview object, and just copy everything, but have the collider a little bit bigger. So as you can see, it's a little bit bigger, and you see there are two colliders. One is a little bit smaller, the other one is a little bit bigger, and this one needs to be a little bit smaller. So the thing we are now going to do, and don't forget, put a layer to build preview. And we're going to change the script a little bit. So the first thing we are going to do is that you can rotate the object. So we need to create a private factor tree of the current rotation. And we are going to change that here. It will instantiate. So if you change the current building, it will directly instantiate as the current rotation. And also, if you instantiate something, it will also be the current rotation, which we are going to change in another part of the script, because that is in this part of the script, where it will check if you are hitting the fire, if the input.getKey down is fire 2, so the right mouse button, it will change the current rotation, or actually add to the current rotation a new factor 3 from 0, 90, 0. So it will rotate along the I axis, and after that it will change the current preview of the rotation of the current preview, and it will change to the current rotation. And then don't add it here, because if something will go wrong inside this, it will just on the next frame it will change to change the current rotation again to the right rotation. And I noticed that sometimes when I was testing this project, if I put it between or in this if loop, sometimes it wouldn't update. So this is just a little bit of a security. And the second thing we are going to add is that you can actually change the building. So the first thing you're going to do is add here to this list another object and called steps, and add the steps and a steps preview object from your folder in it. And we are going to change it right here. We're going to add another void, and we are going to call it switch current building. And what it will do is it will check which key you will actually, or which number you are actually pressing. An important note, later on in this tutorial we are going to create a circle menu, but that will take a few parts to actually create, that you can have a menu like that. If you're following this tutorial, just also watch those that tutorial series. But for now we're just going to do it with our number keys. So it will check which key it is, so it will start at 0, it will be a new int, and it will do it until, and that's important, 3. And that's because we have currently only 2 objects. So, and every loop, every time the loop will run, it will add 1 more. And it's important that you put, I will explain the 3 now, because in the update function, you are going to check if it's actually pressing a key, and if it is 0, or if it is 0, or if it is 2, and 1, I mean, sorry, and if it is, and this number needs to be 1 more than this number, so or the last number of this one. So if you've got 3 objects, just add another one here with input key down 2 and change this one to 3, and at here switch current building. So now we are going to check if it's actually inputting that key. So get key down, and you check this this way, you add E. So now you actually check it, and now you're going to call the change current building, and that's why we're going to here. I think there was a line here in the previous script. This is my 4th time or so that I'm recording this, so just delete that line, we don't need it anymore, because we're going to change this one. We're going to add here an int cur, so from current. And we're going to add here 0 and here E. Oh, that's the wrong one, I'm sorry. Here E. So here we are going to make the current object, the one from the objects, from the list of all the build objects, and from that one the current, and it will check if you have had already a current preview. If you had, so if it isn't null, it will destroy it. So destroy current preview dot game object. So I think that was everything for this script. Now you're going to make that you will have also a child, another collider, that will check if it's actually hitting another collider. And I see I did something wrong. Oh, I'm sorry. You need to change this to quaternation dot Euler, and then at here the factor 3. But here is a collider, and I think I also had, yeah, I also did that here wrong. I'm very sorry. Quaternation dot Euler. So you got here a collider, and it's exactly the same as the other one, and it's just a little bit bigger. And if it hits another object from the layer build preview, from the layer buildable, only then you can create another object. So that's to make sure you can't place random objects, random floor somewhere, and things like that. You really need a foundation. So the first thing we're going to do is remove this one, we don't need it anymore. And we're going to create a bool second, so if the child collider. So if it isn't, you can actually change the color, but otherwise you can't. So that's this. Then also we need to access if you are the mother or the first preview objects, you need to get from the child information, so we also need that, and we need also a transform graphics, and that's what I'm going to explain right now, because not everything anymore on this need is empty is our graphics does have a mesh renderer like this one. You need to you can't have this part of the script anymore, so we need to change this into graphics and then it will work. So now we need to also create a public enum, so a list actually of the object sorts. So normal, or is the foundation, or is the floor, and for that that last one I will come later to explain that one. And also we can change delete foundation. Now we are going to add one last thing, and that is if first we need to add actually the list we just created, so public object sort. So if the sort is foundation, it can stand anywhere. So object sort dot foundation is just exactly the same as I explained last time. But if it isn't, so else, it needs another, in the if else loop, it will need another variable, and that is if from the child collider it's actually hitting something. So child call.count is bigger than 0. So just assign all those variables. So change this one to second. Change this one from graphics. Add the collider. And change from this one that it is a foundation, and only add graphics because we don't have a child collider. And hit apply everywhere. And just test it. And get button down, I'm sorry. But we can hit it and we can change the current building. You see it can only build there. You can rotate it. And well, that was actually everything for this tutorial. Well, I hope you guys liked it. If you did, please leave a like or a subscribe. If you got any questions, please ask in the comment section below, and I see you guys next week.